All right. Hey, folks. Welcome back. This is basically the Battlefront Livestream podcast again. Again, not so much podcast in terms of the way it's released, because that would make it an MP3 or something released through an XML feed. But instead here, or an RSS feed as the case may be, Livestream podcast just in terms of a lot more about the discussion than it is about the gameplay per se. This is a little bit different, though, because rather than being actual Battlefront 2, this is the Battlefront 2 beta. It is early access day number one. Here on October 4th, 2017. So this is my first time jumping into it. Gonna play around with it, look and see what kind of stuff is on here, is available within the beta. As always, for me, of course, this is one of those days where, it being a weekday, I am on duty. Kids are about to start hitting the buses, but just in case, I've got my system pulled up right here, so I can keep track of things going on for them as well. Multitasking, they call it. As we get into this, as we get to some lulls, I'll address how you can get access to this beta if you have been having previous issues with it, as I did earlier today. In my case, I ordered, pre-ordered through Amazon.com a physical copy, and unfortunately, they did not send out the codes that they were supposed to send out to many or all U.S. customers. So we'll get into that as we get to the moments of being like on a loading screen or something where there's not action to be looking at here. And yes, I will be adjusting my position before the actual game comes out. I just need to figure out a better place to put the camera, because the TV now makes it a little tall because we upgraded our TV. So this is the main screen you're going to get when you first log in. Excuse me. We have various goodies in here. We could go to a social hub, which I'm assuming is going to, yeah, let you set up your groups if you have any friends who are online playing as well. I do not. Yes, you are seeing my PSN ID up there, Darth_Soul. You are welcome to do a follow. The new way that PSN works, you can now follow individual people without having to subscribe to them, essentially by friending them, which isn't really what is supposed to be a subscription thing. So I will be at some point going through and sort of pruning down my friends list. So if you are trying to follow and you watch the live streams, definitely do a follow. Don't do a friend connection, because I will be pruning those down to actual people that I know. So we have home. And on home, our options are Galactic Assault Thieves, which is the one that they showed on some of the earliest stream footage at E3 and whatnot, and EA Play. We have Play Your First Match. We have Welcome to Battlefront 2, Watch the Video, which of course we will. And Claim Your Reward, Try This On for Size. We have two unopened crates down at the bottom. We go to play, and we have options for campaign, multiplayer, and arcade. Notice that campaign just says watch preview here, so it looks like that is one we will not be able to do anything with in the beta, more than likely. We then have collection, and we have our different characters that we can play as that can be upgraded through star cards and such. We have our different classes, which are assault, heavy, officer, and specialist here. Then we go down, then we have enforcer and aerial. Fact that the guy has to stand up there. For vehicles, then, we have gunship, ground vehicle, interceptor, bomber, and fighter. If we click on any of these, we're going to learn about what their unique abilities are. The three that are unique to them. It's very much like what we saw with the first Battlefront, with the two that are basically just regular abilities and the one that was the charge star card ability. Okay. And we'll be equipping them and equipping cards as we earn them. Okay, so up to three, and as you level up, you're unlocking access to those other two star cards. So you start with the ability to use one, you have to unlock the other two. If I wanted to go to heroes here, we have Boba Fett, Han Solo, Darth Maul, and Rey available here. And then our hero ships, we have Han's Falcon, which is interesting to call it that, instead of Millennium Falcon, because I guess maybe it's called Rey's Falcon. But you've got your round sensor dish there, so pre-Return of the Jedi. We have Maul's Scimitar, right, the Sith Infiltrator, Boba Fett's Slave One, as opposed to Jango Fett's Slave One, I suppose, and Poe Dameron's T-70 X-Wing. Okay, and again, any of those having cards and such that can be equipped along the way. That's our collection, so those are unlocks and such as we go along. Career is going to tell us our stats, right, for our individual types. Different things to do to progress. So, for instance, here for under troopers, learning the basics, play as an assault trooper for 10 minutes on any multiplayer map. Blaster rifle expert, defeat 50 enemies using blaster rifles on any multiplayer map. So these are things to do progression-wise that get rewarded with credits. So it's similar to doing bounties back in the original game, except they seem to be a little more straightforward, and it's not multi-step stuff. Okay, so there's that. Same thing with the other modes and such here. Options, you have control options, gameplay options. A credit list will be available in the later game, but not right now. Video options to set up your visuals, audio options, and then, in this case, EA account doesn't really need to do anything. There's no separate EA login. It just has you log in as your PSN ID if you're on PlayStation 4. And then, of course, you can go to pre-order and pre-order the standard edition now to receive Yoda's lightsaber mastery. The different skins, right, for Kylo and Rey, blah, blah, blah. Pre-order before October 9th, so you've got 5 days left to do that, by the way, to be able to get Yoda's lightsaber lightsaber mastery star card there. Pre-order the deluxe edition now. Again, make sure it's by the 9th to get those things. Elite upgrades for your troopers are included. You get that 3 days early access, assuming you got access today for the beta. And then that should also include early access to the game itself as well, eventually. Now, for those of you who are trying to pre-order, bear in mind that physical copies have sold out long ago through Amazon. So if you do try to order through Amazon, and you can use Amazon Prime and get yourself at least a little bit of a discount there, because they do discount games, then you're looking at a digital copy at this point from Amazon. Which would have been easier if you just ordered a digital copy through PSN whenever today's clusterfuck happened about the beta codes. Okay, so lots of stuff to check out. Let's check out our unopened crates. These are where we're going to be getting our goodies throughout the game. It's not going to necessarily be just credits where we go buy something. We can purchase crates with credits. But the crates are where the stuff is. Fuzz. So, we can open the Ray Ep 8 appearance crate and the daily crate here. Whee! 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 Whoa! Ooh, it's a something. Inspect. So, Ray's Jedi training skin. Okay, awesome. Go to characters. So I go to Rey. And I can choose change appearance and go from scavenger, which is episode 7, to Jedi training, which is episode 8. All right. Cool. Nice. I can change the emote if I want to, if I have them equipped. I do not, of course. Right now we have, that was lucky, and I think I can handle myself, so.
I think I can handle myself.
Yeah.
That was lucky.
There we go. So we have our lines from episode 7, though she's looking at episode 8. And we have a victory pose that we could choose when an MVP in the game. So I'll go with, I don't care, whatever. Okay, so I got another crate still to open. A daily crate. And a lot of games are tending to go this direction, even ones that didn't do this before. So, I mean, Injustice Gods Among Us is going to crates. Eve Valkyrie for PlayStation VR and Oculus and Rift actually just... Vive and Oculus Rift just recently went to capsules that you open up for random stuff as opposed to gold that you buy with real money. Kind of the common theme now. So, daily crate here. Open! Out come the little bits and pieces. Inspect. Heavy Barrage. Which is a common star card in the Barrage configuration. This MPL multi-purpose launcher fires multiple small grenades. Recharge time starts at 40 seconds. Okay. Why not quick equip that sucker? So Tell you what, we'll worry about that later. I want to see what else is in here. We've got crafting parts. Oh, Lord, we're going to be crafting stuff. And, ooh, Interceptor. Fire Control Recycler for the Interceptor. So another star card. So, again, as you get rewards in the form of these crates, you'll open the crates and get stuff, random stuff. And you'll be able to buy them with credits. So it looks like we got a Starfighter, Trooper, or Allegiance crate. And Starfighter and Trooper are both 1,100 credits. Allegiance is 1,000 even. Interesting. Okay. All right, so let's try out some actual gameplay here. Let's stop screwing around with these menus. Let's do the video and then jump into the gameplay here so we can knock out the stuff going across our home screen. Ready for a video? Roll it. I said roll it. Oh, I get it. It's doing an impression of the EA help site when you try to get your beta code fixed today. That's what that is. Cool. All right. Symmetry. Callbacks. All right. Well, while that tries to load, if by chance you pre-ordered through Amazon or anywhere else and didn't get your code, and really the help process they've set up is abuse intensive, so honestly, anybody who didn't even pre-order can probably just do the exact same thing. But hopefully you'll be honest and do so only if you didn't get your pre-order code. But basically, go to help.ea.com, and instead of doing anything where you immediately choose your game that you want help with using the stuff that's actually on the main screen, go up to the top and click Contact Us. When you click Contact Us, pick then the game that you're contacting them about, which of course is Battlefront 2. Click that. Tell them your platform, in this case PlayStation 4. Tell them that the issue is in the category of codes and promotions. That the issue is invalid code. Yes, there are instructions on the help site that if you didn't get a code, tell them you got an invalid code. Gives you a place to put down a description of what happened. Choose your region, which is North America in my case. Sorry. You'll click to the next screen. You'll put in your name, your contact information, a subject line, a message about what exactly it is that's going on, and hit email us. The first 100 times you try it, it will probably just go into a spinning loading wheel that will never actually do anything. But if you get lucky, let's try that again. You will actually have it go through, and if it goes through, then you wind up, almost immediately they will send you a replacement code for the one that never got sent by Amazon or whoever it might have been. Put in the code, do the download, it's 15.2 gigabytes on PS4 at least, and you can dive in beyond that. It also, I would suggest if you go to help.ea.com to deal with it, make sure you log in to the website as soon as you get there, because if you try to the process without logging in, you'll eventually get to a point where you need to log in, and that also is another place where it might freeze. So always better to just go ahead and log in first. So hopefully that helps. I guess we won't be watching the video. And for those who are watching on here, if it looks like the words are blurry, they are. It's weird. Okay? It's like they're making it so that all the text is supposed to look like the rough edges of a hologram projector. Which I guess is cool stylistically, but it looks like your high definition or 4K screen has crapped the bed and isn't giving you a crisp image. It is, as much as the game is actually wanting it to. Whatever. Okay. Searching for Galactic Assault. Two crates from having a game in Starfighter Assault. Or Starfighter and Assault. Cool. Searching for Galactic Assault. Searching for Galactic Assault. Join in game in 4, 3, 2, 1. At least cancel is R3, so it's not like it's an easy accidental cancel. On the Separatists launch a second assault on Theed, the capital of Naboo, with the intent of capturing the palace and forcing a complete surrender. The attacking team's spawn tickets are added to any remaining from when they completed the phase, and yes, even that text is given that weird shimmer, even though it is smaller. Which makes it a little tough for people with, you know, glasses to read. All right, I can start as Assault, Heavy, Officer, or Specialist. Let's just start as Assault. And I guess I'm waiting. It says players needed 12, so I guess I'm waiting for players to join. Players needed 11. That is one bad thing about a beta when you have a multiplayer game. If people aren't being able to get into it because a bunch of the codes that were sent out don't friggin' work, and some of the major retailers like Amazon didn't bother to send out codes to many of the people who pre-ordered the game, you're not going to have a very large community to start with on a pre-order only right now beta early access. So, 10 players needed. Still waiting. Alright, so my experience today with this was to check again this morning after checking last night, and oh look, no email from Amazon with a code. What the hell's going on? Beta had started. No code. What the hell's going on? So I contact Amazon support through their chat. And Amazon chat support is either run by bots or run by idiots. One of the two, I'm not entirely sure which. If it was a bot, they programmed their bots to not speak English very well or to type English very well and to avoid capitalization at all costs. If it's a human, it was kind of a moron who talked like a bot because he kept saying the same things over and over again. Every sentence this person said in the entire, or every other sentence, I guess it would be, technically, if you actually added punctuation, which he did not. Everything that Alex from Amazon said included the phrase, please do not worry. So, please do not worry this, please do not worry that, blah, 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 please do not worry, and so on. He probably said, please do not worry about 8 to 10 times. The first thing that he answered when I said, okay, well, I pre-ordered, I should have a beta access code. The early access code did not arrive. I need assistance with this. Can you check and see if it has been sent, blah, 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 whatever, right? And his initial response is, please do not worry. Again, please do not worry. You'll receive the code after payment has been processed, which showed that this guy doesn't know what the hell a beta actually is, which is okay, because it's not exactly a common thing if you're not a game player much. But he didn't know what the hell was going on. And I had to explain to this guy what a beta is, that if they only process payment when you ship the item, and that's in November, and a beta is a month ahead, then yeah, you have to send the code before the actual beta. Duh. And yeah, he had no idea what I was talking about. He supposedly escalated it up, and after sitting there for half an hour waiting for him to say something new, I finally said something, and he said, oh, I have now escalated it, and didn't really say thanks or end the call or anything, just kind of stopped responding. So, good on you, Alex at Amazon, you're a douche. So then, thankfully, hey DL, hey Alistair, by the way, I am going to jump out of this and try to get back into it, I guess. Well, no, because I don't have any option to get out of it, do I? Right? I mean, there isn't a jump out of... Wow, so I'm locked into this screen, I think. I mean, I can change options, but I think I'm locked into this screen until 9 more players actually decide to play the Theed Assault. That's something that they could probably stand to fix. Once you get into a multiplayer lobby, essentially, actually letting people get the hell out of it if something is wrong or if nobody else is joining. Great. So, I guess it gives me a chance to finish the story. A buddy of mine had a friend of his who bought something through Amazon Marketplace, had it refunded, and the money didn't show up back in their account. So they received a super secret actual talk to humans technical support line for Amazon. So he gave me that phone number. I called and actually talked to a helpful human being who already was a step up from, Alex, the chat guy, because it was actual English. And she was very nice, very accommodating, saw the issue, and put in a thing, like a support ticket type thing for me. But just like with Alex, the support thing could go through in anywhere from 24 to 72 hours. Well, that's basically all the pre-order period, the early access period. That's not going to do me any good. Oh my god, there's got to be... Literally, I'm just stuck on the friggin' screen until enough people join. I cannot get out of this screen. There is nothing that will take you... Oh, wait, no. Oh, hallelujah. Options button that almost never does anything in most PS4 games. Usually it's circle or something of the face buttons. Woohoo! Actually works. So I guess I'll quit that mode that nobody was jumping into. Yes! But yeah, so she was helpful, but nothing has come of it. I've gotten no emails from Amazon from either situation. Basically screwed. Thankfully, though, that's when somebody pointed me to the EA website. I think it was Pierre was the guy's name, responding to a post that I made. Let's try this again. Responding to a post that I made for the page for my Star Wars Timeline Gold. Hi, Benny. I was kind of talking at the time. That's probably why I didn't say hello yet. So I put it in for EA, and EA basically, it's an automated system, like I said, so it's easily abused. It is heavily overloaded, so you're constantly going to get spinning wheels. In my case, what wound up happening was I wound up with three spinning wheels just left sitting there to see if it ever loads anything on three different browsers on different devices, and not a single one went through. So what happened was when I got back home, I tried it again, until finally, thank God, finally one of them, oh yes, it's actually starting. One of them actually went through. And when it did, the response was almost immediate. It's an automated system, apparently, that's taking these in. And as soon as you tell them you got an invalid code, it's just going to shoot you a code through email. So in a matter of seconds, the email showed up, gave me the code, and I was able to download it. So do not, if you're an Amazon customer and you got screwed over by this whole thing where they didn't send out your pre-order code, I would not suggest going through Amazon. The time it's going to take to go through Amazon is going to suck up all the time your early access is in the first place. So go through EA. Again, help.ea.com. Use Contact Us up at the top. Choose the game. Choose your platform. Have the issue be under codes and promotions. Say invalid code. Tell them it's not so much an invalid code, but that you never received your code. And just keep trying it. Keep trying it. Be patient, and eventually it hopefully will go through. I hope it'll be easier once we get to 9. Howdy, howdy. Is it Matthias that I hear pronounce that? And thank you. I'm glad you did. Glad you're loving. He's talking about A Saga on Home Video. Fan's Guide to U.S. Star Wars Home Video Release. My new book that came out in May. All right, so controls pretty much standard first-person shooter so far. We've got aiming with the right stick. We've got strafing forward back with the left stick. We've got running by clicking the left stick. We have a jump. We do have sort of a cool-off, right? So R2 is our trigger. Square is doing our cool-off. Circle is crouch, apparently. Triangle's not doing anything yet. I can go R1 to switch between weapons. L1 throws a grenade. Cool. L1 and R1 give me another type of weapon. And that one looks like it's on. Actually, that and the grenade are both on a cooldown. Okay. Nice. Okay. And we are to take out the MTT. So here we go. And let's see. Can we switch views? Yes. All right. So holding down the down button on the D-pad jumps us in and out of third person versus first person. Once you are in third person, you can shift shoulders by pressing it again. Cool. So kind of what we expect from a control standpoint. Looks nice. But then again, Battlefront 1 looks nice. Something that says pick up. Ugh. All right, so here's an ion disruptor. Pick up the square. Oh! All right, interesting. So I'm guessing that is a hold down square as opposed to hit square. All right, let's stick with assault for now. All right, so I'm supposed to pick up. It says pick up ion disruptor. And I see another goal there that's locked at 153 meters at that point. So I'm assuming that picking up the ion disruptor is a necessary first step. It's not just... Oh, there's our melee, right? Which is right stick. Yeah, MTT there is... Oh, now it says attack, so somebody must have hit it. Something. Whoa! Holy shit! Got killed by Boazon in the... Total battle points, none. I'm assuming that up there, based on the pre-launch videos that we've seen, I'm assuming that up there. Well, it says take out the MTT, so it could be the MTT's health up at the top, or that could be an indicator of how many troopers we still have accessible to us. Whoa, there's a transport. Whoa! Somebody must be inside that thing.
Grenade out!
Good to know, Alistair. Thank you. It says that if you die any battle points, you get, you keep. Oh! Yay, I actually killed a droid, and that must have been a headshot, because otherwise, that is an incredibly fragile droid there. Oh! Got one and then died. Okay. Combat and... Okay, so that's telling me that the other player, not only is it telling me its weapon, the player's weapon, it's showing the star cards that are involved, which is similar to what we had from the original Battlefront, so that works. They just look different. Got our map there on the bottom left I haven't even really taken much of a look at. So what do we have? There's a standard blaster here. Versus... Alright. Somebody's picking up the, or was picking up the thing. I'm gonna get out of the way because I don't want to get blown up by that tank. I'm gonna try to go around. It is a nice atmosphere. I mean, the design is nice. Graphically very nice. Again, I would expect this game to be high-end graphically because that's the way that the first Battlefront was. I wouldn't expect that to slip behind. The question is whether or not the gameplay is going to be significantly better. And I would love to know who's shooting at me. Did I get... No. I damaged the player. All right, so everything you do is bringing back... Okay, reinforcements available. Interesting. All right, so reinforcements available. Okay, pressing the thing above out there just gives us that screen. Reinforcements. No, although it is telling me you can play as a hero to up to 40 players. Vehicles are available in Galactic Assault mode. Let's see. I'm trying to figure out how... Okay, so it says reinforcements are available. So how... Nope! Grenade! Wrong button! Nope, it's not that, and it's not one of the other D-pad buttons, looks like. Run! Alright, so we need to defend this guy, so he's got the... by Darth Maul. Alright, so I can change... Oh, that's cool. Alright, so I can change weapons if I like. If it's unlocked. Alright, let's jump to heavy.
Back at it.
That is one of the things that's been on people's minds quite a bit, is whether or not they're ever going to bring back classes, and ta-da!
FTC hit!
They have.
We're stopping its power! Hit and run. They know where you are.
Surely there's like a specific part of the MTT you're supposed to hit. Nice. Star Force Media, are you going to be picking up a PS4 or a PS4 Pro? Out of curiosity. Speaking of PS4 Pro, if you didn't catch the announcement, they just announced that the PSVR is also getting a refresh. Slight form factor change to make it easier to deal with headsets, which is not a big deal for me. Slightly smaller cords, not a big deal for me, but it's going to have the ability to do a... Whoa! Damn. damage, but not killed. It's going to be able to do a HDR pass-through on the box, which hasn't been possible before. Okay, reinforcements available. So, and? Where you pick up your trooper, you can pay battle points for a vehicle. That's when you found it. Okay. Oh, okay, so that's this. Gotcha.
Damage to the transport.
That's why those have lit up there. Okay, so let's... Let's jump back to heavy and stick with them for just a little bit. Okay. Boy, I wish there was an explanation for some of this stuff. I'll say that the battle droids on Theed kind of remind me of the stormtroopers on Hoth in that they blend in quite a bit with the background. Whoa!
MTT behind the fire! Ion disruptor on target!
Dang, I was hoping that explosion would work to take him out. Dope! See what the heavy's even got. I haven't really been paying attention to what he's actually got. Okay, so heavy's got a shield. Nice. Heavy's got
no use stopping that MTT now.
A grenade also. Heavy's
got.
Oh!
Oh,
shebang!
We hold back those droids long enough. We can
nice.
Get reinforcements. Throne room doors are sealing. Protect the control station.
This is actually the first match I've been able to get into. I was stuck behind the mess of Amazon not sending out the codes. And then the first attempt at joining anything didn't work, so... This is numero uno. Numero uno. I hear somebody coming out there, probably with a lightsaber, so I'm gonna get the hell out of here!
Atomic grenade!
Damn.
They're transferring control. Together.
Woo. This is Jet Trooper, I guess.
Yep. Squad has re-secured
the West
Mike
Cat, were you able to get a hold of your
Ready
code
go.
If it wasn't
Next
sent correctly?
Coming in.
Like, were you able to use the EA help thing? If not, you might want to rewind the feed. Fairly early on while it was trying to load, I went through how you can use EA help to get it. Ah! Yeah, get to EA. Yeah.
Blast door control's being overridden.
If you use EA support, you should be able to get it almost immediately if you use the method that I was describing earlier, which is basically send it. Whoa! That was a waste of using a guy.
Too many of them.
So yeah, help.ea.com. Log in with your EA account, or create one if you don't have one. Let's see what an officer... Actually, I want to try that Gatling gun first. So, log in with the EA account. Go into EA.
My time. Fight with honor.
Basically, tell it... don't use the regular help. But on the help.ea.com page, click on Contact Us, choose Battlefront 2, choose your platform, choose codes and promotions, choose invalid code, and tell them that it's not an invalid code, that you just that your code was never received. And then it should be something where once you go into email it, you should get the email almost immediately. Like, mine came in less than a minute. There'll be two emails. There'll be one that says that, like, thank you, we've received your email. And the other one says, here's your code, basically. Assuming you get a confirmation that it went through in the first place, which is my problem, because it took forever to get a confirmation. All right, so what's this guy have? We got a pistol. Oh, he's screwed now. Got a turret, looks like, and a couple other things that I guess I should wait until something actually going on. Whoa! Oh, that's his Gatling gun. He's got an explosive of some kind, but I didn't see what it did.
Got your back.
3,000, 5,000, 5,000. Dang. So back to the officer again. Sure, why not? Grenade out! So this must be the second, at least the second stage of this. Don't let the palace fall, okay? Meaning, I guess it's a control point kind of thing? That didn't give me any kind of extra, like, bonus or anything. That just gave me a nice yellow circle around me.
Let's go. All right.
Let's try specialists. Mike, what platform is it? PS4 or one of the other ones?
Unidentified enemy now landing.
Pardon me. So yeah, it looks like a shot grenade. Zoom to detect enemies, R2 to tag enemies. Oh, okay, so you can tag enemies on line of sight.
Got a distance! Ally deploying!
Whoa, turn it off! Turn it off! Run! Freaking Darth Maul, Sith Lord, bull crap. Ah, there's a droid with a shield. I think it's gonna take a while to get used to.
Got your back. We need a surge, or the palace is lost.
Back to the song, why not? Heavy is probably who I'll wind up going with most often, I would think. But we'll see. Oh! Defeat! It's defeat!
All squad, evacuate the city. We'll take the palace back another day.
Interesting. So kind of cool. Thanks, Ace. Kind of cool that they provided like a little quasi-cutscene there at the end. But at the same time, I'm also thinking, are we going to see that same scene every single time? And isn't that going to get real old real fast? Objective completion score, assists, team support score, damage done, credits earned, not many. Yay! Challenges. So getting like the bounties there. Okay. Q. It says next round starts in however many seconds. I'll do at least one more of this type and then see what else is out there, if there is anything else that's available. Yeah. We shall see. Learning the basics is like, wow, you got more than half and you suck that time. Way to go. I'm not entirely sure why every time I try to sound like just a goofball or something, I wind up sounding like I should be introducing my two brothers, Daryl. You know, and that my name would be Larry. Surely there's someone old enough to remember that reference. So now we're on the droids. So we've got not enough points, but we've got MTT, Vulture Droid, Tank... Tri-Fighter, Boba Fett, where? Hyena Bomber, Super Battle Droid, something else that looks like a Super Battle Droid, maybe a jetpack.
Landing incursion complete. Way to
Come on now. We got stormtrooper, well, clone troopers lined up to execute, and these droids are just, like, shooting through. Hey, maybe you guys could, like, help us? They're coming right for us, guys! You douche nozzles. Okay. I'm assuming there's no... Yeah, there's no actual cover kind of play again, which is kind of typical. What, can he not jump? There we go. feel like I need to have queued up a bunch of the little Clone Wars era droid comments like, why? When I die. Or, I just got a promotion. I've been seeing way too much of that. I've been recording, for those who don't know, I'm launching a Patreon on October 17, which is the 20th anniversary of my Star Wars Timeline Goal, or Star Wars Timeline Project.
Grenade out!
And once I do that, the exclusive item, or one of the exclusive items, is going to... Hey, I'm your... aren't we on the same side, you nit? No. But yeah, eventually... there'll be a codes. Those who do the Patreon thing will have access to some Clone Wars commentaries that I'm doing. And the Clone Wars commentaries mean rewatching the Clone Wars to record them, and that means a lot of battle droid goofiness. It's interesting they got them designed so that at least they don't all look quite the same. Looks like Assault is as plain as you can get. Similar weapon loadout. Looks like the weapon loadout actually is identical. Just looking at those symbols versus playing with Assault with a trooper a moment ago. There are a lot of things as part of the environment that you can't do squat with, though, that's kind of weird. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, because on the one hand, it does mean that we got a bunch of useless crap sitting around, but on the other hand, it does at least mean that the environments feel fleshed out, as opposed to kind of feeling hollow. Hollow's not the right word. Empty's. Empty is what I was looking for. Alright, defend the MTT and defend the Ion Disruptor. Okay, I should actually try to aim for the stuff. Now, these symbols are, I guess what? Class symbols? So, wait a second. I get it. This is Battlefront, but it's all designed after American politics right now, right? Because the whole thing is about class warfare. Sorry. Continue the escort. I'm a history, political science, etc. teacher, so of course I gotta find that funny as hell. Do you have an emote? I have no emotes, apparently. That's not a thing in this game, apparently. So, oh no, I just don't have them. I haven't earned them yet, so they're not equipped. That's what it was. Saw that a little bit ago. Hey, Creepinator. Yeah, my plan is to get the Battlefront Livestream podcast going again once Battlefront 2 is out. And if I can go through and actually get my friends list cleared out of people who are... that I don't actually know, who just kind of did friended me because of this, then I can clear out enough space that I can start to add people, like, right beforehand and maybe get some people in on the live stream in the squad to play as we're doing the live stream, which was always kind of a tough thing with the first Battlefront, because there was no difference between following and friending someone, which is something they just added with firmware. It was 4.5 or 5.0 or whatever it was they just put out for PS4.
Forming squad.
Officers. Okay, specialist. There we go. With his sniper rifle. That is going to work a little bit more the way that I would tend to probably play most games. I even use a sniper rifle basically when I'm playing Eve Valkyrie, which is a starship fighter game. But they've retooled it so that your different ships are equivalent to, like... if it's a first-person shooter, an assault rifle, an SMG, a sniper rifle, or a shotgun. So you have an easy way to sort of tell the different play types for each type of ship. And I use the Strix, which is basically the sniper rifle.
MTT taking damage.
Increase protective measures.
Well, if I can find them. I will. Yeah, I'll do that here in a bit. Where are they at? Whoa! Okay, so I'm being shot from somewhere. I gotta get used to this, this little wannabe, map again, because I have no idea where I'm being shot from.
Mechanical damage to the transport.
I'm assuming that's in, as opposed to, like... electronic damage to the transport or something, because I was tempted to pull a a Jack Nicholson. Is there another kind? Oh, shit!
Grenade, arm!
Not sure at all what I just did, but... Go for it. Scribner says, this sounds Clone Wars Target Exclusive DVD brand new for $15, Blu-ray brand new for $50. Nice! Now, do they have the comics with them, Creepinator, like they're supposed to? Because that was my thing. I was finding the DVDs and the Blu-rays, but I wasn't finding them with the slipcover or the comic most of the time. Which is a pain in the butt.
The Republic has a new ally. The Republic has a new ally.
But yeah, I know that's what it's supposed to have. I was trying to make sure that the one that you got actually had it, because a lot of times they don't.
FT has reached waypoint 2.
Damn,
further attacks must be intercepted.
Uh-oh! Heard that. Wom, wom, wom. Behind me. Blu-ray is just the standard Blu-ray plus digital combo. So not the comic with it for the Blu-ray one. Let's go back to
squad assignment accepted.
Squad assignment accepted.
I need to see what exactly it is it's trying to show me on that screen right before it launches.
Ion disruptors affecting the transport.
Get and destroy the ion disruptor. Hey. Okay, so then that's not going to be a Target exclusive then if it's just a standard Blu-ray. Gotcha. Because either of the Target exclusives from the time would be the comic included in both. Well, on the plus side, I killed the guy.
Warning, enemy morale has increased.
Yeah, Mike Cat, what I did when I was getting a spinning circle for more than about a minute and a half, I would hit refresh. And it would reload the first of the pages that you fill out, do that real quick, and submit it again. I even took the things that I was putting inside the text boxes. Stay close to the teammates to earn a bonus score. Oh, there you go. Nice. That's what that symbol means. Oh, no, that just symbol means heavy. But yeah, that way I could just copy and paste in the information into the different boxes quickly and just keep refreshing every time it didn't work, and eventually it did. Although it took a long while. Go around and kill him.
The enemy has a new squad commander.
The enemy has a new squad commander. That's not good. By Asian boy 1234567, who will eventually grow up to be secret Asian man. Had to bring in some Da Vinci's notebook there. Wow, so we just got our butts kicked on like stage one. All right, so this is kind of like the last one that they added for Rogue One to the original Battlefront. Where if one side doesn't get the first one, doesn't win the first phase, it goes to the second phase. But if the other side doesn't win the first phase, it just ends. Okay. Actually, no, I said I was going to try out a ship. I'll jump into one more of these and make sure to try out a ship support this time. Because I didn't. Twenty-seven. Oh, man. For those who are wondering, I'm checking if you can scan the stream. I teach online, so all of my stuff is on my computer here. So I just have it sitting out in front of me, so if anybody needs something, I can grab it, or if I need to cut the stream early, I can. So far, not so much, but this is the time of day when usually the kids are on the way home on the buses or just heading out. Most of the high schools get out between, like, 3:30 and 4-ish. Eastern. All right. So I'm back on this side again, instead of switching.
Interesting.
Let's try a heavy. Equip weapons. Okay, so that's crafting. So that's where the other weapons are coming in. So when you get your crafting materials, like I got in that container, crafting materials 600 in this case will get you the CR2. Okay, so that's where crafting comes in. At least part of where crafting comes in. Good to know.
Landing incursion complete.
So crafting is going to be what you're using to unlock specific things. I love the fact that you got the citizens there in the middle running like hell. That's kind of cool.
Feats don't fail me now.
And they go running. All right, we gotta get that ion disruptor thing over here. Stop the clones from taking it. Did George just say goodbye, grenade? And did I just see Ray in the beginning of this match already? I see people running over here. Okay, maybe not. The Rogue One target exclusive for the Steelbook. I'm not sure what you mean there, Creepinator. Dang, that didn't work.
Incoming.
Oh, please chase me. Oh, which do I prefer? I like the target exclusive because you got more options. Plus, it's the only one that has that extra DVD of some content. Whereas the Steelbook doesn't have that. But the Steelbook and Target Exclusive both have what I want the most in my Star Wars release, which is it's got the 3D Blu-ray included as well. So, yeah. Love me some 3D Blu-ray, even though the format is dying. Woo-hoo! My wife. There you go. My wife usually gets a refill when she's got an MTT. They just bring it to her. When it's sitting at the table with an empty glass. For her sweet tea. We're in the South. We don't do that sun tea stuff. It's all sweet tea or nothing. Or in my case, nothing. No go again? I said just keep trying. Keep plugging away at it. I got a feeling that's what, my co-host, what Michael is doing, too, from Cloud City Casino. Our plan was to be able to play the beta this morning a little bit and record a podcast for Cloud City Casino about the beta this evening. But that's not happening now because he's still trying to get access to the friggin' beta.
Increase protective measures.
Fun! Yeah, if you have a PlayStation 4 and a PSVR, you can watch 3D Blu-rays in PSVR now. So at least there's that, and there's still a market out there for for projectors. It's just the actual standalone TVs for 3D that tend to be gone from the market now. I'm assuming my situational awareness will eventually get better.
Yeah, right. Our forces have reached the first waypoint.
Yeah, we've reached the first waypoint. And I did nothing to help, and that is a lot of freaking birds. Is this like a Prince video or a John Woo film or something? I do feel like the weapons and the aiming are more spot on this time than they were last time. It takes a little more skill to aim them, but that also means that they don't feel quite as loose. And there's a little bit more of a feel of difference, which is something that I complained about a lot for the first game, was that all the weapons felt like they didn't have much weight, and it just, regardless of what you were playing with, the way it felt in your hands pretty much felt the same. And that seems to have been addressed fairly well this time. An enormous freaking map. And the fact that it's a street, there's a lot of open space to get shot. Predictions for 8. I'd like to think that all the stuff they're talking about how different it's going to be, is going to actually be true. That it really is going to have a cool different tone. What I want to see is a Battlefront update. I would love to see if they're, because they said they're going to keep adding content to it, but it's all going to be free, right? It's not going to be a season pass or anything like that this time. I'm hoping that whatever they do in that regard, that there will also be some story-based or single-player new content added. That it's not all going to be multiplayer. Like, maybe an epilogue or something that's not necessary, but adds to the story that we get in single player.
Alert! Republic attack damaging the MTT!
It's got the little red thing telling me somebody's there, but I don't see anybody. Sorry, I've been listening to a lot of Hailstorm lately, so a lot of it's stuck in my head. In the chat, the support link. The only support, the one that works, it's help.ea.com, and use the contact us link up at the top. Do not go through the normal either of the two normal options that are in the middle of the page. Go up to the top of the page and choose contact us. And when you put it in, make sure it says it's under codes and promotions, and you tell it invalid code even though you don't have one, because that's apparently what they are answering from. Not even answering, but they've got it. God damn! What they've got it set from. You know, I was getting popped by a sniper. I just couldn't figure out where it was shooting me from. Okay, reinforcements available.
Squad assignment accepted.
Let's try a tri-fighter. Do or do not, there is a tri-fighter, so Yoda can shut up. Interesting perspective on Yoda in relation to the whole Chosen One thing and which Skywalker he intended to ever train. If you read from a certain point of view, the book that came out, the anthology book that came out this week. Okay, so left and right on the left stick is roll. Forward and back are speed up and speed down. Regular steering is with left stick. Zoom in with L2. Fire with R2. And then you got your abilities off there to the side. Whoa! There we go. And it used to slowing down by just pulling this back. I actually just bought, well, didn't just buy, my wife just got me for my birthday a T-Flight HOTUS 4 Thrustmaster flight stick. God, this is a fast vessel. I cannot slow down enough to get some good strafing going on attacking the ground. This is as slow as it goes, it seems like. Wow. Okay then, not sure this is gonna do me any good. Good God. I mean, seriously, as fast as that was going, I wasn't gonna be able to do anything. I gotta shot down enemies up in the sky, but there's no way I'm gonna be able to do anything on the ground. I can't maneuver fast enough. Or maneuver precisely enough, I'll put it that way. Because I'm flying, but I'm like, breakneck speed the entire time. That was the slowest setting on that vehicle. That was with the stick all the way back to nothing.
I'll stick with Darth Maul.
Now, is this cyber... Oh, I guess that'll be a costume or a skin to get, like, cybernetic leg Maul. So right now, Maul is very much the ZZ Top Maul, right? He's got legs. He knows how to use them.
Follow Maul. Oh, God. Oh, God, we're all gonna die.
Whoa! Ah, somebody's up there on the top of that thing. Ha-ha! I actually used a tiny bit of strategy just then. For real! A tiny bit of strategy! Yeah. That won't last long.
The MTT is in position. Clear the area of clone resistance and prepare for phase two.
Ooh, prepare for phase two.
The palace throne room has been sealed. All units proceed inside and override the door.
I'm assuming that's supposed to be a tactical droid talking. It'd be kind of cool if we found out that Kalani didn't want it. How do I get up there? There's no way I'm going to be able to jump that. Some players didn't kill anybody. Damaged some.
Roger,
yeah, I got a feeling heavy is going to be my go-to. I was thinking assault there for a second, but yeah, heavy. Because I love the Gatling gun concept.
A new ally has landed.
That's great. Oh, nice, Mike. Did you finally get it?
Get back here, you fat bearded bitch.
Oh, come on. I hit him with a sniper rifle. Isn't that supposed to be a fast kill or something? All right, we're inside. So, heavy maul, heavy officer. And defeat already. Oh yeah, the N1s can fly over it and not get completely destroyed. Sure. Alright. Scratch mine ear. It is cool also that they're showing five instead of just three people at the end. That's cool. Gives you more recognition. Nice. Leveling up seems relatively quick, at least at this point, but of course we know that's probably bound to change. All right, let's see what else is available. I'm going to have to remember whenever I do live streams of this, whenever I do the real thing, I'll have to turn the music off. Otherwise, it's going to constantly wind up getting flagged by, whatchamacallit, flagged by YouTube over and over again. Oh. Ooh, our next meeting for work is on October 13th, Friday the 13th. Ooh, we got some crates! And I ain't talking the dragons! Hello, Connor. Alright, what do we have? We have heavy and assault starter crates. Alright. Open crate. What do we have here?
A clone on me!
Heavy common weapon. Like, it would increase the range, lower the rate of fire, and increase the damage. Sure, why not?
Yeah!
Heavy. Kryptonite charge. Uncommon star card. Okay. If MVP select 3. Common victory pose. Okay then. Assault starter crate.
We're a team.
Smart ion grenade. So it's empty there. Got boost cards. Can't do anything with these yet. Okay. So I have to, I guess, acquire them first. I can't equip that one. So the iron grenade that automatically detonates near enemy shields and vehicles. Okay. MVP select 3. Again, another pose.
Let's go.
And CR2, the thing that I would have had to unlock with, whatchamacallit. So we got the DC-15A standard issue blaster. This has better cooling power, lower range, higher rate of fire, and lower damage, it looks like. If I'm reading that right. I'm assuming that when, that since this is already showing in the gray boxes, when I click down, the gray boxes don't change, so that must be telling me where this new one is going to take it. Did I ever try BD Live on any of the Blu-rays back when it was heavily advertised and what I think of it? Rarely, if ever, because usually it was kind of lame stuff most of the time. Okay. Okay. So we have start collecting upgrade with star cards. So assault. Change victory pose. Choose MVP select. Okay. It is kind of nifty that it's set up in such a way that these panels that are showing up on the home screen are changing depending on what I have and haven't done. Let's see if we can get that video to load again. It was not able to load when I first attempted this a little bit ago. Let's go ahead and give it a try now. Okay. Tegodana! Indoor looking, or Tegodana. Space, that's probably Fondor Shipyards. Iden Versio!
Hi players, this is John Boyega.
What's up, John?
Joining the Star Wars Battlefront 2 multiplayer beta. Today, you'll experience just a small taste of what the full game will have to offer at launch. But we're excited to get you into the game early.
Hooray!
Before we begin, let me give you a rundown of what's in store for you this November. Whether dominating the multiplayer Battlefront as Kylo Ren, leading your squadron through thrilling dogfights in space, stepping into the boots of Iden Versio in a new single-player campaign, or mastering your skills in the arcade mode. This is a Star Wars experience like none other, with greater depth and progression than ever before.
Greater depth and
Star Wars Battlefront 2 has nearly triple the number of locations, heroes, and vehicles as its predecessor.
Ooh, so
it
triple compared
to the Battlefront.
Not much.
Over 14 locations to explore across all three Star Wars eras.
Over 14?
In today's beta, you'll
like
have
15?
A chance to explore Naboo, Fondor, Takodana.
Cool.
Star Wars Battlefront 2 introduces class game.
The video that was released
choose from the assault,
about 2 weeks
heavy,
ago, I think.
Specialists and officer classes, each with unique abilities, weapons, and weapon attachments that give you an edge in battle. But it's not all about the power of the individual. The better you play with your team, the more battle points you'll earn to call in powerful reinforcements, such as clone drum troopers or B2 super battle droids, and a wide range of vehicles, both on the ground and in the air.
Yeah.
Battle points are also key to bringing iconic Star Wars
heroes
into battle.
Okay.
In today's beta, you'll experience 4.
Okay, now that's... He's saying that differently.
On Solo.
Bet, Han, Rey, and Maul.
Each hero has unique abilities for you to customize and master. Choose the right moment to call in your hero and turn the tide.
Give up.
And last but not least, we have starfighters.
I wonder if they got
just
a...
Just like troopers, each starfighter has a class. And just like battle
Star
points
Killer,
bring your favorite
my
heroes into
the
battle,
name's escaping me right
they can
now
also
to
bring
do the
in your favorite
again.
Hero ships, including the iconic Millennium Falcon, all with unique handling and upgradable abilities. The Star Card system has been completely rebuilt. These powerful collectibles exist for everything you can spawn in as, be it a trooper, a vehicle, reinforcement, or hero. In the beta, you'll get a taste of the customization available in the full game.
There we go.
with a small selection of star cards to get you started. You can find them in crates, or craft and upgrade them using parts. The rarer the tier of card, the more powerful its effect in battle.
Signature's locked.
Choose the right star card for the right situation, and get ready to fight. Star Wars Battlefront 2 contains five different multiplayer modes.
That's it?
In today's beta, you'll get a chance to play three of them.
I guess if you get single player and objective-based arcade stuff.
Starfighter Assault.
Ooh, that's what I wanted to add.
Intense dogfights across high atmosphere and space. And Galactic Assault. Epic 20 versus 20 all-out warfare. Not ready for multiplayer yet? No problem.
Like Walker.
Perfect your skills and try out all of your abilities in the arcade mode. Play co-op, versus, or solo, and earn rewards.
And earn rewards. That's important. Be able to play something that's not multiplayer online and still earn stuff.
An untold story.
That is important.
Help him bridge the events of the Return of the Jedi and the Force Awakens.
So what happens now?
We retaliate, Commander.
As Iden Versio, a special forces soldier as equally lethal on the ground as she is in space,
like Boba Fett
for
says,
the future of the Empire, from, the galaxy,
from a certain point of view. The boss says, Boska,
wanna find
we
out
Boska.
More? Prepare to jump into Iden's story yourself this November.
Notice the Imperial Raider, the Corvus there, originally
Star
created
Wars
for the X-Wing miniatures game.
Is a massive world. And today's beta is just a small slice of what you experience
Armada.
In the full game at launch. Until then, make sure you check out what's coming up in the daily calendar. We have a whole host of challenges to keep you entertained, including rewards that you can carry over into the game's launch to get a head start this holiday.
Now, carry over stuff from the beta into the real deal.
Multiplayer
nice.
Beta.
Though you know somebody's going to say it's pay to win, because if you pre-ordered the thing, you got access early to the beta. Not only access to the beta, but access to the beta early. And some of the stuff will carry over, so you got an unfair advantage, etc., etc., etc. Okay, so challenge yourself and earn rewards. What do we got? Play the Heavy Trooper. Play the Specialist. So I got to play the Specialist a little bit more. And Starfighter Assault and Officer for these. There we go. Okay, so timed challenges. So I guess that's the amount of time spent playing? Or does time challenges mean that they themselves are going to expire? All right, I'm going to play. Campaign, multiplayer arcade. Campaign is a preview. It says, play the single-player story fight for the Empire's Commander Iden Versio, leader of the Special Forces Unit Inferno Squad, of course, introduced initially in Battlefront 2 Inferno Squad, the novel by Christy Golden. That's actually pretty good. Good moral questions if you get a chance. Also read Rebel Rising, similar moral questions from a different perspective. The next episode of Star Wars Beyond the Films that gets released, which is over at StarWarsReport.com, will be me and Mark Herleman talking about Inferno Squad. Nice and timely.
Pre-Emperor is dead.
So what happens now?
We retaliate, Commander. The Empire will assault.
That's her dad, and he's kind
of
a dick.
The rebels' pathetic belief in themselves. Tell me, Aiden. What is the source of their belief?
Hope.
Correct. This messenger's presence is a great honor.
Ah, what are the Emperor's sentinels? As introduced in the canon, things like Shattered Empire.
Admiral Versio.
Is this thing on? I can't hear myself.
Resistance.
Can you hear me now?
Defiance.
Effing Verizon.
Concepts that cannot be allowed to persist. You are but one of many tools by which these ideas shall be burned away. Heed my messenger. He shall relay you to your target.
Operation Cinder is the last command of our Emperor.
The last command.
The first step in securing our future. Inferno.
The last command is no longer you will kill Luke Skywalker.
What's our target?
RJ.
You are not verified.
That information can wait. For now. Here are our next assignments. They are unusual. But these are unusual times.
Nice graphics.
Go, Commander.
Step up from the Force Unleashed.
Do what you do best.
depending on how well their motion capture went, as we see the rest of the story progress, it may be comparable to something like an Uncharted 4.
Kill some rebels. Oppress the galaxy.
Star Wars Battlefront 2, we promise you're not playing as ISIS. Multiplayer and arcade, let's try multiplayer. We've got Galactic Assault, Starfighter Assault, Heroes vs. Villains is not available, but that is, of course, one of them. Blast is not available. But, again, Heroes vs. Villains should play like the original Battlefront game. Blast should play like Team Deathmatch in any game, but just like Blast in the original Battlefront game, which gives us Starfighter Assault, which should be similar to Fighter Assault. Strike, which seems to be a scenario-based thing, kind of like Control. And then Galactic Assault's the one we've tried out, so let's try Starfighter Assault. 24 players, 12 on 12. I like the fact that you're not jumping between different loading screens over and over again. At least not long ones. There are loading screens, but it's none of the, oh my god, I'm gonna go, like, drink an entire soft drink while I'm sitting here waiting for the friggin' loading screen to go through. As was the case with Battlefront. Though I will say, most of my Battlefront gameplay was on a PS4. Now I'm on a PS4 Pro. Loading times may be even different.
There's a Star Destroyer cut through repairs in the shipyard.
Cool.
Vulnerable, but far from defenseless.
Alright. I can choose a T-65B X-Wing. I can choose an RZ-1 A-Wing. Or a BTL-A4 Y-Wing. Han's Falcon and Poe's T-70 X-Wing are my other. So three initial options, which is better than before, because it used to be just two, and then they had the cloud card that sucked. And two hero ships to choose from, as we eventually had in the other game. Let's go with an X-Wing, of course. No cards to equip, I'm assuming. Yeah, you can see them, but you can't do anything with them. Because you need to actually get access to them. So we have Astromech Repair Instinct, restores a small amount of lost health, fires a proton torpedo, fires a missile that tracks the locked target and deals damage, and then weapon overcharge increases primary weapon damage for a short time. So notice no shield on the X-Wing this time, which is interesting. Chalak, there is no campaign for the beta. Closest you can come is watching that preview, which is one cutscene that we just watched for the campaign. The beta has apparently, it looks like arcade mode is available. And then within multiplayer, you've got Starfighter Assault, Strike, and Galactic Assault, but not Heroes vs. Villains or Blast. And I haven't looked at Arcade yet. So, unfortunately, we don't get a chance to actually jump into the campaign at all during the beta. We just get a chance to see sort of where it kicks off with that extended cutscene that goes beyond what we saw in the previews, even though some of that was in the previews. That's all right. We've only got about a month to wait, right? Give or take. It's not too bad. Right.
Our forces won't stand a chance with those cruisers in place.
We got in cockpit. Again, same controls. It is closer up than we had before. Whoa! Oh, nice. And it's giving us a, looks like a lead indicator. So if you've never played, Eve Valkyrie. Whoa! A lead in... Ow. Oh, it's tough to get used to controlling this again. Oh, and it's got... I've got my, I may need to invert my sticks. If you've never played Eve Valkyrie, one of the things that it... And it's 2D now, by the way. $30 gets you Eve Valkyrie, Eve Valkyrie Warzone, the full upgrade. Love that game. Started as PSVR only, but now you can play it outside. But when you get close... Okay, well, clicking down the stick apparently is a boost. When you get close to an enemy in Eve Valkyrie, you'll see something like this, where you've got this weird... Like, the targeting reticle is on that ship, but then there's this weird leading indicator right out in front of it. That's basically telling you where to shoot in order to actually hit the target because of their distance and speed. Which is pretty cool. Eat that, Rabid Wookie!
Blockade runners are here.
Square and
keep
triangle
the
don't appear to do
and they will deal out serious
Square,
damage.
Triangle, X. Oh, triangle is Now, triangles sort of even me out again. That helps. I'm not getting any boosts, so maybe I have to wait for a boost. I'm assuming there's specific places I'm supposed to target on this. Like the weapon emplacements.
This will be impossible.
Whoa! Yeah, I don't know about this whole the roll is just moving your right or left stick. I may have to do some key binding.
All right, everybody, let's get this
done.
Though
this would probably be pretty cool to play with the Thrustmaster.
Keep at it. Structural failure imminent. Finish them off.
Oh. Damn it. What the hell is happening? It's like I get underneath it, and all of a sudden the controls aren't working correctly. It's like the turning isn't working correctly. Which I'm assuming means like I'm inside its shields, or I'm being bumped from behind by an unseen turret or something. But it's like the controls just literally just stop being responsive when you get right underneath the air quickness or something.
Red leader, reporting for duty.
The cruisers are down. Scanning for additional defenses. We've lost the blockade runner. I don't like our chances if we lose another.
Enemy down.
Nice. Okay, so that targeting just now was clicking R1 to get access to the proton torpedo, then holding to lock, and once locked, letting go, and then pressing it again to fire. Now, this used to be the mode I was best at, was Starfighter. You notice I say it used to be.
Y-wing squadron has joined us. Cover them so they can perform a bomb.
So lock, fire. I'm not seeing where my health is indicated, though. Is that on the left hand? No, left hand side is boost. Is that what the 102 is up there, I guess? Uh-oh! Whoa!
The Y-wing squadron successfully completed its bombing run.
Okay, so that's, right on the D-pad right there. Down on the D-pad. After playing in VR, I love the interior view in VR, but I still hate it from outside the craft. Because I don't feel like I see enough. Alright, outside the craft. Okay, say it again. In VR, I love the interior view because you can see enough. But in non-VR, regular 2D mode, I do not like the interior cockpit view because you can't see well enough. There you go. So I prefer the outside cockpit. And I've been doing a lot of inside cockpit stuff on games that I usually wouldn't do that with. Try an A-Wing. Like Drive Club VR, the racing game, I've actually been playing a bit by... Unlocking a test here. By using the Thrustmaster T80 racing wheel. That I was able to get for like $30 when it's almost a $100 racing wheel. Having a lot of fun with that. So. Whoa! Stupid! Dove a little too tight there. Dirt-da-der! Hey Nathan, the initial hot take is, oh my god, Amazon effed this up. As far as sending out the codes. But then once you actually play the game, I feel that it has improved beyond the first one. It's definitely a tighter experience. It feels more polished. It's definitely a prettier experience to some degree. I think it's going to be the campaign that really sets everything apart. I do feel like the matches are a little more complex as far as what your goals are. I'm still trying to get used to... What is this? Still trying to get used to the different controls, though. And there aren't any quick button press 180 kind of things either for evasion, which is what the other one used to have. But Nathan, I've only played a couple of matches, or 2 to 3 matches of Galactic Assault, which is Naboo Battle for Theed or whatever it's called, and this one Starfighter Assault. But Starfighter Assault has more than just straight team deathmatch in space mechanics this time. Not sure what that is. Let's try it. Oh, that's, you know, strange.
Another down. Making headway.
Whoa. Wah. Whoa, blasted from behind by Ty L.N. Yes, L.N. Ship of the Line. Let's try a Y-Wing. Bomba. So it looks like it's launching us all at the same time so that we stay close. Maybe. Don't know what that just did. Ion cannon turret. Do not know what that just did for me at all. That's okay. I'm assuming this is bombs.
Our numbers are starting to get thin. Wrap this up or we'll have to disengage.
Whoa! Mother!
You can't take much more!
Shit. Yeah, I do like the heavies in this one. All right, and different.
We've lost too many. We'll retreat to fight another day.
And this one only shows 3 instead of 5. Interesting. I'm wondering what we get for the ranks. I'll try one more of these before I switch to strike. So playing okay, it seems, is likely to get you at least one
all forces repel
reward box assault thing. About once, I guess, every 10 or 11 matches, on average, it looks like. TIE Bomber, TIE Interceptor, TIE Fighter. Yeah, it is nice to finally have a reason for why the fighting is happening in Starfighter Assault instead of it just being a big furball. Everybody kill everybody! Go! I'm sure there'll be people who are bitching like, man, I just want like a team deathmatch style thing like the old one, man. I mean, you're not going to be able to keep everybody happy. You'll barely be able to keep anybody happy. You're EA. But it's possible to keep a few people happy most of the time. Interceptor.
Entering attack mode. Keep the rebels
away. Protect Imperial defenses. Okay, that is R2. Okay. Boom! Bye bye, Carrot Juice Box. That's such a name that you make tighter turns at slower speeds. No, no kidding. Really? What do you think? Oh, and TIE Interceptor's got a missile.
Y-wing squadrons appeared. Do not allow them to complete their bombing run.
Destroy bombers before they can attack. All right, what bombers? Whoa!
Y-wing bombers are getting through. They must be stopped.
Oh, there they are.
The first step in their plan.
Now, are those players? Yeah, I guess it is. So, hey, we finally get to play as a Y-Wing instead of just calling upon one. But every single one of those said dice shoot. Closer than I thought. Objects in the front view screen are closer than they appear. Splat.
We got your back.
We've lost one of our cruisers. Default to the one remaining.
Whoa. Okay, so L2 is like a crazy, or L1 is like a crazy speed up. Target lock? Target lock on what? Here's a thing, thinking Isaac gonna die?
Both cruisers have fallen. We must redouble our efforts.
You mean we gotta do it like times four? We double them, now we gotta double them again? You see, I'm gonna die soon. I've been sitting there waiting to die. Hero vehicles for the Empire are, although maybe should be called villain vehicles. You got Slave One and Sith Infiltrator. A.K.A. Scimitar. Let's try regular TIE Fighter. So far, so good. Better than the first one. It's gonna be story mode that makes or breaks it for me, though. I haven't seen any skin modifications or anything like that for ships yet, off the top of my head, but I know that there are some, because you can get the Force Awakens / Last Jedi version of Millennium Falcon in the main game. And I have seen skin modifications for characters.
Y-wing bombers, keep them from reaching the dock.
Oh, shit! Ah! Better than Battlefront 1? Yes. More, as in more content? More focused content so far. It's hard to say if there's more or more. Until we actually get the final game. Whew.
Down the shield generators, our destroyer is next.
So what is this? Oh, damn! What the f- I haven't heard anything yet about campaign length, so we'll see. We shall see. Steven, so far so good. Like I said, it's done some Starfighter Assault and some Galactic Assault, and so far, good. Feels tighter, more refined than the first one, which is not a hard stretch anyway, right? The first one. So what are its abilities? I've got a multiple missile lock, electronic countermeasures, and dual photon torpedoes. And it's very pretty. I'll give it that. It's definitely very pretty.
My ship's becoming non-functional.
My ship's becoming non-functional, he says. Basically means, oh crap, my stuff's broken. Oh shit, I did it again. I flew right through and took an immediate left and slammed into it. We're gonna remind me again what's in the $90 edition, and I can let you know what I think to that. And I'm assuming $90 you're meaning digital, because the physical Elite Trooper Edition, which is the one that I'm getting, which is the highest end one you can get on physical disc, was $80, I believe. On Amazon, with Amazon Prime, it's like with taxes, maybe about $68. Go! Go, go, Interceptor! Technically, it hasn't fallen. It got blown up. So, you know, it's not the shield generator's fault that it got blown up, lady. Come on. Be nice. Yes, I'm assuming they're out of there. Still play Vita? Not really. I mean, I played, my plan was eventually to replay all the Uncharted games. That never happened, even though I got the Nathan Drake collection sitting here. But right before I was going to start replaying them, I replayed Golden Abyss, which is still pretty awesome. But beyond that, now I haven't played my Vita in ages. Dang it. Although, honestly, except for trying to get through Middle Earth Shadow of Mordor on Xbox One, for the most part, I've been playing PSVR games almost exclusively lately when I do have a chance to play anything. 2 days early access to full game, upgrade weapon for each class. Hey, we won. Wait for goalie. Whoa, that was pretty sweet.
The rebels will think twice before daring to attack.
It's like near the end of a Rogue One where the Devastator jumps in and one of the smaller ships runs right into it. Cool. Pre-order skins and upgrades. So, yeah, I mean, from what I understand, for the most part, it's like a head start kind of thing. So, we'll see. All right, we're gonna jump to a different mode here. Make sure I got my right screen up here. Yep. Oh. Hot up in here. All right, let's go back to multiplayer again and let's try strike. Searching. 16 players, so 8 on 8. Let's get some fan going here. And it's so bright. Click. Get the fan going so I don't die. And there we go. Tikodana! So there we go. Finally playing on Tikodana. The First Order have intel that Maz's castle might be a location sought after Jedi artifact, but the Resistance aren't going to let them take it without a fight.
Okay.
And Maz's castle still exists, and yet the Resistance and First Order are going to fight there, so non-canonical, apparently. Big shock. Got any cards? Nope. Hey, you got any cards? Nope. Any different weapons? Nope. Okay, so that's one of the new weapons I got, and one of the new cards I got. So let's start as an assault one. Flame Trooper looks like, and Jump Trooper are the two other options. Ah, they do have the... Oh, that's true. It does look like they've got the highlights on them. You just barely see the way that the character model's holding them. For some of them, not all of them. But that is good. 15, 14, 13, 12. That tells you up there in the corner all the time, in case you forget, it's beta. Beta, 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 beta. Be ironic if they put the beta up there in a blue box and with white text instead of red, because then it would match the old beta VHS tapes of Star Wars. Or beta VHS. Betamax cassette tapes. See, I'm not used to saying Betamax cassette instead of VHS cassette. Usually people just say Betamax, it's just Betamax. Go, 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 pick up the artifact. Go, 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 wee, go, go, go. Oh. Come on, guys, we gotta get inside. Get up somehow. Oh, there's a door. Oh, and I got blown up. Didn't even get to do anything. Got blown up.
Got your back.
If you had my back, I wouldn't have died the first time. Another door that opens. Yes, it is. Oh, shit! Was that Bodhi? Or not Bodhi. Looked like a Baze Malbus. But no, that was just my eyes playing tricks on me.
Let's go!
It was just my imagination.
Let's take 'em.
Alright, guys. It's not suck this time. Come on. Hoorah for the not sucking! Woo! 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 All right, somebody go in the door so I can shoot inside the door. Uh-oh. Where the hell am I getting shot from? Gotta get up on top.
You and me, we got this.
No, we don't. Don't lie to your people. Gonna wind up being like the original Battlefront where I sucked terribly until like right near the end of its life cycle. Did my grenade ever explode? Guy up on top again. Okay, so now I gotta figure out how to get up on top.
We'll stick together.
That's where I've been shot from twice now.
We've got the package moving now.
Well, at least my death let that guy know that there were rebels around the corner. Interesting that it's giving me a reminder of my star card each time. First Order, that's name apparently has two different completely contradictory origins. The First Order is to survive, or first .. order, as in the first priority is order. Oh my gosh, that sucked. Oh, shot from behind.
Let's go.
Oi! Oh!
The package will have to be acquired again.
We're moving with the package now.
Okay. shot by a sniper rifle.
I'm at your side.
I'll stand by you. Won't let nobody shoot you in the face with a sniper rifle again. Oh crap! It's a proximity grenade, not a... Oh, is he dead now? No. He dead now, though!
Package secured. Move to extract.
I don't know. I guess it's something that I'm sure I'll train my eyes on over time, but I'm finding it harder to spot the enemy in this one than in the original. Probably because the lighting effects are so much better. I mean, look at this. There's individual shadows coming from shadows and lack of shadow coming from breaks in the tree line behind me as reflected on my armor. That's insane. Okay, next time I actually hit him. Awesome.
Hurry and seize it again.
Covering fire! Can be concurrent with TFA or blatantly non-canon. Based on the way that it was described, blatantly non-canon, because they're there looking for an artifact. And the resistance is in full fighting form, which was not the case. The resistance didn't have ground forces during TFA.
We served
at least in the Battle of Takedana, so it sounds like blatantly non-canon. Which is fine, because that's what these types of modes are supposed to be. It's when it's story mode that's meant to be within canon. It's just the original game pissed off people by not having story mode, so it had no impact on canon really whatsoever. Ah! I got killed by Huck Finn. By Huck Finn, I got killed by Tom Sawyer's little buddy. I got killed by a Samuel Clemens character.
Reinforcements are here.
Which is really sad, because I just finished watching Time Zero, the two-parter from Star Trek The Next Generation, and he was kind of a douche. At least that version was. I guess I could stand to use my shield. I forgot with the heavy, I've got my shield available. On the map, I see red. And now I owe Metallica $2. Oh, I see you. I see somebody with something there. Oh, damn, there he is.
Reinforcements are here.
Beep, 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 boop. Respawn time seems about the same. Maybe a tiny bit faster. Kind of hard to say. Whoa! Get in there, get in there, get in there. Oh, shit balls!
Right with you.
I heard a Wookiee just now. That helps.
Throwing grenade! Okay, okay, take a point!
Whoa! Not sure exactly what that weapon does. I thought for a second I blew myself up.
Finish the job.
We'll do it together. Alright, so we're at 5, but 5 what? 5 lives among the team, just as far as like number of troopers, the same way that it was back in the original Battlefronts? It looks like it. So it's not a time limit, it's a deaths limit. So playing this in the, I screw it, I'll just go and do what I can before I get killed thing actually does not work anymore, because getting killed actually speeds up the end of the match, and your team's loss. I kind of like that. Because the last game was basically nothing but a cannon fodder game. Until you busted out a hero, and even then some of the heroes might as well have been cannon fodder. What's this one I don't have yet? Receive a heavy starter crate. I've already done that one, so why is it showing it as if it's not done? I have 600 out of 600, and it's showing as if it's not done. I'm so confused! What the? It was counting down, and now the countdown is starting all over again. Nice. Very nice. Oh, this is specialist, and you can be... Oh, so you got options of a Wookiee or... Who are you? I guess just a jet trooper. But really, if you took the... Seriously, if you took this... Take the specialist here, right? Take the specialist design. Combine the specialist design with this jump trooper design, right? Is anybody else seeing that somewhere in between is Jan Ors? Eh? No? Maybe it's just my connection to Kyle Katarn, since he was in my only... in-universe Star Wars story I ever had.
The First Order got wind of an artifact here in Takodana. And they're sure to do everything
universe.
They can to get it.
In
protect the package and do not
Legends.
Let it reach the extraction point.
Alright guys, let's do this. I'm gonna do this one in first person so you can see that, since I haven't done much in the way of first person this time. There isn't anything beyond aim down sights like this. I can't like switch and look through what looks to be a scope. Which is stupid because it's, you know, a scope. But no, I can't look down the scope. Telling me there's an enemy behind us.
Package is moving. We have to intercept.
Coming through.
All right, so that's a shotgun, basically, that you're unlocking with that. Apparently.
First Order, drop the package!
Ooh, First Order, drop the package! Who's Santa Claus now, mother... Ooh, that was nice. I was turning at the time that character said, keep your head down! And I got a nice 3D sound effect kind of thing going from it. This is something that I actually can't wait to play when I'm not on stream, because we just got set up. I know, we're a little behind the times, but we've now got you putz. We now have a, whatchamacallit, a, oh, smack! Smack, smack, Huck Finn. We now have a 5.1 surround sound system. Granted, not 7.1, but a nice 5.1 surround sound system that I've been optimizing, so I'm eager to be able to play this and hear the sounds on that 5.1 system, which just really can't come through the headset. Yike. Oh, smoked by Big A. Which means that if he was hiding inside
package,
a cage, it would be a big A-hole. The hero. Oh, wow. And they send the heavy troopers in with vacuum cleaner appliances. I wonder if when I use the Gatling gun kind of thing, the repeating blast, or heavy repeating blast, if it switches me to third person. We shall see. Oh, how did I not kill either of them? Seriously. I'm spraying them from like 2 feet away with a repeating blaster of some kind. And they're just like, oh, that kind of hurts. That tickles. Stop it. Instead of actually, you know, dying. Exactly, Mike. It felt like a leaf blower just then. It looks like it and felt like it. Now, if I have the shield on, can I Oh, you can shoot with your shield on.
Oh, shit.
I don't know where I'm getting shot from. Probably from behind me. But you can shoot with your shield on. Something you could not do with the shield in Battlefront 1. Yay!
Let's go. I'm with you.
I'm with you too.
They're stealing the package!
We can do like a skin of this on PC and make it all... you know, Democrats versus Republicans and stuff like, they're stealing my healthcare! And stuff like that. Come on, how funny would that be? They're confiscating my guns!
Package has been dropped!
And like your victory pose would be a finger showing whatever amendment you chose to highlight. Fourth Amendment, bitches! And, like, your different skins would be, like, different presidents from that particular political party. As a bonus, you could, like, unlock the vice president so you know that, you know, someone's really badass if they're coming at you with Joe Biden. For Amtrak! Bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum. Or something like that, I don't know. Reminds me of there was a somebody did a fighting game that I think was based on Great Scientists or something that actually got made. Get into cover.
That's a lot of fire coming out of that thing. Stop them from leaving with the artifact. I'm just trying to figure out how to kill some people.
Don't throw when you're near me. I'll see where it came from. Slowly getting used to this map system. It feels like it's been refined a little bit since the last game. The little mini map. Not heavily so. But a wee bit, at least. Yeah, I knew I was gonna die that time. I was shooting him in the stomach from far away and barely touching him.
Let's go.
He decided to come out of his big a-hole to come after me. I'm gonna switch it up.
Shall we?
Shall we die? Sure, we're an officer. We have like a regular little pistol there.
I think I can handle myself. Boom, boom, pew, 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 pew!
So probably the last match I do on this stream, I may stop it and start it again in a little bit, but usually if it's going to crap out at an old apartment as opposed to at our house, it would crap out after about 2 hours.
Enemy has dropped the package!
Sounds like Michael is trying to get on there.
Let's do this.
Ready to go.
Ooh, Amazon issued me a 1 cent refund on The Force Doth Awaken. because apparently the price dropped by 1 penny since release this week. Well, going to Vegas with that money, man. Ah, I was about to shoot him with the sniper rifle, and he got me first with his rifle. Let's see
ready.
How you like it.
With you.
Oh, how's the lake look? Let's see. Let's see if I can smoke that guy over there. Is he back? Is he still over there? Are you still over there? No. All right.
Retrieve the package.
Go to third person. It looks watery. Nothing super special. Like it's, I don't notice. Like as I'm walking, it is not like it's rippling around my legs or anything. So there's not a lot of heavy water physics designed into it. It doesn't seem like. But apparently you're not supposed to walk in. Damn it, walk in
taken
anyway.
The package.
Secure the package.
Damn it. Hey, I got you from way over here.
At your back.
There's one thing I'm not liking in
Got your back.
I'll go back to first person for you. One thing I'm not liking in Eve, now that Eve Valkyrie has been updated, is
enemy forces picked up the package.
Well, I did already with this one. The fact that the Strix that's supposed to be the sniper rifle analog doesn't really feel like a sniper rifle because the range isn't all that good. Ah, come on! Where the hell did he shoot me from? When they go to show where the person shot you from and you still can't see them even when they're outlined in red, something's up.
We're not done yet. By your side.
Yeah, it's gonna take a while to get used to the... Well, take probably long enough to play all through the beta. Get just used to the idea that it's not time-based, it's death-based. That you can't just run into battle and just be cannon fodder, because if you do that, you're gonna screw your team up. Still over there? Huh? Ah, but you can't run when you've got the shield up.
You maneuver, I hold here.
Yeah, got one.
Let's go. By your side.
The blast hit him so much in the midsection that he was cut in half. He was thrown and severed and cut in twain. Right, Huck Finn? Twain?
Twain? Get it?
Weird just happened just then, as far as what it was showing me underneath the weapons. I wonder if it's like overheat R2.
Rig to blow.
Yeah. Yeah, the castle design's pretty cool. It reminds me of, one of the Tatooine maps for Walker Assault, where it really feels like the structures and the design actually helps you on the original Battlefront. I forget which one off the top of my head. Ah, finally! Okay. Wookiee, Jump Trooper. Wookiee,
package secured.
Jump Trooper. Let's try a Wookiee. Oh, no, I can't. I don't have enough, so let's save up.
I'm with you.
Maybe save up. I'll probably not get enough time. So, whatever my next respawn is... I'll probably go to whatever. Oh, okay. Hello?
Surround that area.
Really? Seriously? an area that there's no way out of if I go this way. That was kind of a waste of time. He keeps telling me there's someone behind me, but I don't see someone. Need to get used to the idea of, like, running for the trees instead of staying directly underneath because somebody who's up on the parapets could kill you. Ah, that is true. That did look like the door where the saber is in the film. Nice catch. Brilliant! A luminous beam, so to speak.
Carrier down! The package is on the
ground! Alright, guys. They're coming this way. I'm assuming you can't jump up on the ship. Although, I bet you could if you had a jump... Jetpack. That's not gonna do us any good. I'm stopping them from escaping. Which is true. I wonder if the artifact is the lightsaber. I haven't actually seen the artifact that got picked up. Though wouldn't that be interesting if it turned out that,
the package has been returned.
The first... Oh, come on. Almost got him. That the First Order knew that that's where, the lightsaber was.
By your side.
Nah, bro.
With you.
Just in case I get spawned somewhere out there again. I know you're still up on the rampart, son. I'll check for you. Oh, he is! Oh, I missed him. Come on, Butt Nugget.
Package on the ground. First Order dropped it.
Come on! Where'd you go?
First Order has the package.
Booyah!
Going dark.
Ooh, that's cool. I don't know what that means. I mean, I know what going dark means, just I'm wondering what it means from a gameplay perspective.
The package has been dropped!
Uh-oh. Pop your head up again, my friend. I do not bite. Whoa, how am I not in the mission? Okay. Get back in, get back in. Be the one that I said earlier.
The First Order has the package!
Deploying grenade!
Hostile, headed your way!
Oh, he dropped down. That was a slick move right there. I'll give that one to you. That was actually a slick move. I'm assuming the distance to target is the thing that I'm seeing in the line underneath the 11. Guys like that. And the artifact is in the box. It is probably Luke's saber. Nice. shot by Rogue Chaos. Oh, I got enough battle points.
Let's do this.
Ooh, we're in overtime. There is such a thing as overtime. That's cool. Not entirely sure what overtime means. How are we in overtime? Overtime as compared to what? Uh-oh, and I'm dead. Well, that didn't do me any good to play as the fucking... Or the freaking Wookiee.
The artifact is safe.
Got him! Somehow. In overtime that started for some reason. Gee. Surprise, surprise. I'm assuming that's where the victory pose comes in. On that screen. Quit. Okay. Quit. Okay. Quit. Cancel? Quit. Okay, there we go.
That was a little weird.
Quit and okay just kept sending me back to the exact same screen again. Is it sending me to the menu? Like I'm trying to get it to. Okay. I have two unopened crates. Let's see what's in the crate. Heavy's got some new stuff in the collection. A new victory pose. There we go. Yeah, MVP select. So if you're an MVP on that last screen, it'll show you'll get to use one of the poses that you choose there for change victory pose. Gotcha. Have I said anything about progress carrying over? They haven't said what carries over, but they've said that stuff, that there is something about what you're unlocking and playing with here that will carry over to the regular game. I haven't seen anything that specifies what. It's the last thing I'm going to do before shutting down, by the way, just get these. We got Specialist MVP Select 3. Specialist A280 CFE. What Jin used? And the Stinger Pistol for the Specialist. So, Starfighter Starter Crate. We've got... Bomber Advanced Capacitors. Fighter Cooling Systems. And Interceptor Advanced Capacitors. Now, I wonder, given the fact that it's showing as Rebel Imperial Rebel... if that means specific to that ship, or that just means for that class of vehicle, regardless of which side you're on. Because, again, going back to making the Eve comparison, Eve unlocks are ridiculous. You have a crap ton of different paint jobs and decals that you can get, and there are 13 types of ships. And even though it's the exact same paint job, you have to unlock it 13 times to be able to have access to it on each ship. It's not just a paint job you just apply to the ship. So... hopefully this will be a little bit less grind-heavy on the unlocks, or a little less greedy in terms of buy stuff with real money to get access to more capsules. I don't even know if you're going to be able to use microtransactions to buy more crates, but I'm assuming you'll be able to. All right, so let's check it out. What else do we have up here? We got career. Where are we now? Go to specifics about the different types of challenges for each. Oh, that's what we didn't do. We didn't do an arcade mode. Crap. I guess I'll try one arcade mode real quick. Didn't even think about it. Solo co-op versus. Versus is not available in the beta. Co-op is for split screen or solo. Battle scenarios? Scenarios with classic encounters across all eras of Star Wars. Complete them all to become a formidable combatant and earn unique rewards. Bring a friend to team up in split-screen co-op. Then we have custom arcade, set up however you want, and tutorial. Those latter two only available at launch. Let's try battle scenarios. We've got light side, which is not available yet, and dark side, which is. And then, wow, there's quite a few for arcade. We have wipe them out. And roger, roger. Let's try this. Darth Maul wields the power of the dark side to crush the Galactic Republic's pathetic clone army. Time is short, but the power of the Sith is strong. Purge the halls of Theed Palace and leave no troopers standing. Available characters, Darth Maul, and I think that's a jetpack super battle droid. You had the different tiers, starting time of 20 seconds? Minutes? Enemy classes available there, all four. Enemy difficulty normal, intensity high. The other ones are available at launch, the different tiers. Eliminations 25. Okay. Sure, why not? Wipe them out. Darth Maul wields the power. Oh, I already said all of that. Use Onslaught as a training ground to get fast, effective kills as a hero. Come on! Fortunately, nobody needs anything yet, but still! Okay, it's a B2RP rocket droid is what that was called. With a twin wrist blast, or Darth Maul with Darth Maul's lightsaber. Of course I'm going to be Darth Maul. Defeat 25, I'm assuming that is 20 seconds. Or is it? 20 what? Alright, and... Alright, kill another one. Oh, kill another one. Makes you feel a little badass. Oh, shoot. Okay. Killed. Finally. Okay, there's his health down at the bottom. I wasn't even sure where his health was located. Each one I'm killing is giving me more time towards killing. 20 seconds. But it's not. Oh, crap. One kill remaining. Yeah, I got him. Victory. Minute and 1 second, I guess, used? Star and credits. Remaining. Well, that's interesting. That was quick. Kind of fun. So I guess for those who are checking out the beta, we should, get a sense then of what is available, or again. So in the beta, you have the ability now. You cannot play the campaign. You can just watch a preview that is basically a cutscene with preview stuff attached to it. In multiplayer, you can try Strike, you can try Starfighter Assault, you can try Galactic Assault. You cannot do Heroes vs. Villains or Blast yet, but those are modes similar to what we saw in the previous game. In Arcade, in Arcade, we have the option of solo or co-op, but not versus. Under solo and co-op, we have the option of battle scenarios, not custom. And if we do battle scenarios, we only have the option for dark side, not light side right now, and we have wipe them out and Roger Roger available. So, you know, it is kind of what you'd expect from a beta. It's a relatively light thing, but the fact that you can earn star cards by getting crates and whatnot, doing the different challenges and such, it gives you a chance to play with all four of the different classes and some of the different heroes. I think that for a beta, this is nicely fleshed out. It gives us enough to give us a sense of what the game is going to be like. I would actually argue that this beta is more of a full preview than what we got with the original Battlefront. So in that sense, good stuff here. Not a big fan of the way that they do the font with the weird interference stuff going on the menus, but that's just a minor quibble. Definitely liking the way that the characters feel. The classes do feel a little different from each other. The weapons do feel a little different from each other this time. Which is good. Now, what I really want to know is, was that foreign website, wherever it was, Germany or wherever it was, correct in saying that there was an indicator that's going to be on the packaging that says a VR component is going to eventually be added? Ooh. No idea yet. Not a clue. But yeah, so that should be it. If you missed any of the stream, feel free. This will process here. A 2 hour, almost 2.5 hour stream will probably process for about an hour on YouTube, and then you can check it out on the channel again. And when you come into it, then you can just watch any part jump around if you like. If you are playing again on PlayStation 4 or any other platform, but especially PlayStation 4, and you ordered it through a pre-order retailer and you did not receive your code, again, help.ea.com is where to go. Do not use any of the two main options that are on the center of the screen when you get there. Use Contact Us up at the top. Choose Battlefront 2. Choose your platform. Choose codes and promotions. Choose invalid code. Even though you don't have a code, still say invalid code. And make sure you pick your region. Then give them the information about how you didn't receive your pre-order code when you were supposed to. And when you finally do get it to go through, instead of just doing the spinning loading wheel, so you're going to have to probably try multiple times, when you finally do get it to go through, they should send you a beta code relatively quickly to allow you to get in. Is it going to be exploited by people who didn't actually pre-order? Of course it is, but if they didn't want that to happen, they should have had their shit together in the first place in terms of making sure everybody who pre-ordered actually got the codes they were supposed to get. But that's how you get to it. If you haven't, I'll be playing some more on this. I'll be definitely doing some more streaming with the Battlefront 2 beta later this week. But for now, that's it. Thank you for watching. If any questions come up, feel free to drop them into the whatchamacallit, into the comments once the video is processed. But we'll see more Battlefront 2 beta definitely tomorrow sometime. Thanks for watching.